We've all heard of carbohydrates and we all think we know what a carbohydrate is. And yet somehow there seems to be this endless debate between a very loud group of people who say carbohydrates are bad news, you shouldn't eat them, they are sugar, they are just sugar. And then an equally vociferous group of people on the other side saying that's ridiculous, carbohydrates are not sugar, carbohydrates are something else. It's much more complicated than that and they have health benefits. How is it possible, with the knowledge we have now and the science that we have now, that we are still able to have such an argument? Well, the answer is that both sides are right, and that sounds ridiculous. So in this video, I'm going to explain to you why both sides are right. It's just a misunderstanding. Welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. I'm an athlete, so I've used a lot of carbohydrates in my life. And it got me thinking that there has to be a simple reason for this endless debate. Now, I did a video very recently on cartilage, and there's a big debate about whether or not cartilage can grow back. And that's just as acrimonious because both sides of that debate are talking about different things too. So if you want to understand why that one still happens, I'll put a link down below to that video. But this one is about carbohydrates. Now, there are two different ways of understanding what a carbohydrate is. Firstly, as a chemist or a biochemist, the understanding of a carbohydrate and what that means, it means a sugar molecule or a compound molecule made up of a number of sugars linked together. That's it. That is all it means for a chemist or biochemist to say carbohydrate. So when somebody is using the chemical definition of a carbohydrate and they say it's just sugar, it doesn't matter what carbohydrate it is, it's just sugar, they are right, because chemically that is true. But the other people who are not chemists, not trained biochemists, and are not even talking in the context of chemistry, they're talking about nutrition and food groups. When they talk about a carbohydrate, they're talking about a food type. Because in order to try and understand our nutrition, we've taken every kind of food we can imagine and put it in one or other bucket that we loosely call the protein bucket, or the fat bucket, or the carbohydrate bucket. So in the carbohydrate bucket over here, we'll have things like pasta and bread and cereals. And over here in the protein bucket, we'll have things like meat and eggs and fish. Now, a piece of steak is not a protein. It is if you're talking about food groups, but it's not protein. Steak has fat on it. Fat's not protein. Fat is fat, but you don't put the steak in the fat bucket, you put it in the protein bucket. Because why? Because there's a lot more protein in fat. The main constituent nutrient is the protein. Now, here's a shocker for you. That steak even has sugar in it, because that animal has been eating grass and converting the cellulose and the starch from the grass into glycogen, which is like animal starch, and storing that in its muscles. And glycogen is sugar. So there's a sugar storage in the muscle, and now you eat the steak. So it's not just protein, but it's mostly protein. And the same goes in the carbohydrate bucket, where your rice is, for example. It's absolutely correct for somebody who's talking about their food to say, if rice is a carbohydrate, then carbohydrates are not just sugar, because a grain of rice is a seed. It's a grass seed. Now, it has a lot of sugar in it in the form of starch, but it's a seed. That means it carries the DNA for the rice plant, because it has to be able to grow into a whole plant. And DNA is made up of amino acids, which are the building blocks of proteins. So there is protein in a grain of rice. If it hasn't been refined and processed, it's got some fiber in it. It'll have some vitamin B1, it'll have some iron. So it's got more than just sugar in it. So this person who's referring to a food group is quite correct to say carbohydrates are not just sugar. The chemist who's talking about the definition of carbohydrate in chemistry terms is talking about sugar molecules. Then carbohydrates are just sugar. Of course they are. Sugar is sugar. Okay, now, here's a question for you. If I had a bowl of sugar in my hand, is there anybody out there who still thinks that would be a good idea to eat? No. And in this hand, I have a strawberry. Would you eat that? Yeah, that seems okay. It's got a bit of sugar in it, but surprisingly low in sugar. And it has a lot of antioxidants, and it has some useful vitamins in it. So a strawberry is a pretty healthy thing to eat. Fine, I'm going to take this strawberry, and I'm going to bury it in this cup of sugar. Are you going to eat this now? What, a whole cup of sugar to get the strawberry? No, I don't think so. That's what you're doing when you eat rice. You're eating all that starch and kidding yourself that you're getting some protein and some other nutrients out of the starch, out of the rice. So carbohydrates in food group definitions are not just sugar, but they are mostly sugar. That's why we put them in the carbohydrate bucket. But just understand that when you next get into an argument with somebody and they're telling you what a carbohydrate is and what a carbohydrate isn't, and whether it is just sugar or whether it is not just sugar, you're probably talking from two different directions and you're not talking about the same thing. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe. Please don't miss any of our videos. I'm going to make some new videos on sugar, which goes more into what sugar actually does to us and why we need to control the carbohydrate intake and what makes sense and what doesn't make sense, and try and clear up some more misunderstandings. Thank you for your time.